So in last stanza, Ivan said to governor, the most important thing was that call which came before the exam ended. And like a fool, I presented you with that little piece of information on a plate. And governor said, like a fool, I was so fool, I presented that correction slip to you in which all the information was written. Do you remember that correction slip which was sent to Ivan to make some correction in Janma question paper? Well, somebody did. So you see, sir, that correction slip killed two little birds with a single stone, didn't it? So he said, see, that slip killed two little birds with a single stone. So two things happened. The name of the hotel for me, I got the name of the hotel. And at the exact time, the exam started for her. And said he, the exact time exam also started. The governor noted, it is pretty common word. Good job, it is pretty common, sir. Or I would never have known where to come to. He said, yes, it was a pretty common word, but without that word, I would have not known where should I go or where to come. Nice name, though. Zum, golden, and lion. How did you know which golden lion it was? There is 100 of them. So, Ivan asked governor, how did you know about this golden lion? Because there are 100 of them. Same as you, Ivan. Index number 313, center number 271. Remember, 6 figures. And if you take an ordnance survey map for Oxfordshire, you find that the fixed figure reference 313/271 lands you bang in the middle of the chipping order. He said, I took the number 313 index number and 271 center number. And when you find out in the map, you come here. Yay, you are right. Who? We had hoped you would run off to Newbury. We did. He said, it means you must have think that, you must be thinking that I would have gone to Newbury. We did. Well, that's something I suppose. So, Evans is saying that I suppose you must have thought that. That question paper, Evans, could you really understand all the German? I could hardly. So, a governor asked Evans, can you really understand the German question paper? Because I understand it hardly. Nee, of course I could not. Of course I could not. I knew roughly what it was all about, but we just hope it would throw a few spanners in the work, you know, sort of muddle everybody a bit. He said, I don't know, but I knew it roughly, but for somebody who doesn't know it will be a little bit difficult, confusing to me. Sort of muddle means something confusing for. The governor stood up. Tell me one thing before we go. How on earth did you get all that blood to pour over your head? And governor asked, tell me one thing before we're going. How did you get so much of blood which you put on your head? Ivan suddenly looked a little happier. Clever, sir. Very clever, that was. How to get a couple of pints of blood into a cellar. He said, it was very clever. How to get couple of pints, mean unit of blood, in the cell. When there is none there to start off with, and when. And when the invigilator, shall we say, gets searched before he comes in. Yes, sir, you can well ask about that. And I do not if I ought to tell you. I do not know if I ought to tell you. He said, it started all when the invigilator came. You can ask him also. After all, I might want to use that particular, because I wanted to use that particular things which he brought. Anything to do with a little rubber ring for piles, perhaps? So governor said, is that rubber ring which he brought for the pile? Ivan grinned feebly. Clever though, wasn't it? And he started laughing. It was very clever. Must have been a tricky job sticking a couple of pins. Nah, you have got it wrong, sir. No problem about that. A governor said, it would have been very much difficult for you to put that blood on your head. He said, you know, it was not the problem. That was not the problem. Nah, it's a clotting, you see. What was the problem? Clotting. When that it dried, that was the problem. There's the big trouble. You have got the blood easily. Pig's blood. It was pig's blood. It was from the slaughterhouse in Kiddington. But to stop it clotting, we have got to mix your actual blood. He said, it was, we got it from slaughterhouse, but if we want it should not clot or become dry, we have to mix our blood in that. Ivan took a breath. With 1/10 of its own volume of 3.8% trisodium citrate. He said, this one we have to put in that. Didn't know that, did you, sir? He says, I think you don't know this. The governor shook his head in a token of reluctant admiration. Now he wanted to admire also, but he was reluctant to do that. We learn something new every day. They tell me, come on, my lad. And Garner said, yes, we learn everything. Every day we learn something. So now my lad, my boy, come. He once made no show of resistance, and side by side, the two men walked slowly down the stairs. So they came down without any resistance. Tell me once, how did you manage to plan all this business? You have had no visitors. I have seen to that. You have had no letter. He said, how did you manage these all the things? No visitor came to meet you there and nothing was there. Then also, how did you manage it? I have got lots of friends though. What that's supposed to mean? My German teacher, for a start. He said, I have so many friends. But Governor said, what does it mean then? What to do with the German teacher? He said, he was my friend. You mean, but he was from the technical college. Was he? Evans was almost enjoying it all now. Ever check up on him, sir? He said, but that German teacher was from technical college. He said, and Evans was enjoying telling. Did you ever check it? Governor said, God almighty, there is far more going on than I. He said, my God, how many things are going on and I don't know them. Always will be, sir. He said, always will be like this. Everything ready, asked the governor as they stood by the reception desk. The vans out the front, sir, said the pretty blonde receptionist. Evans winked at her and she winked back at him. So van was ready, receptionist said, van was ready, and Evans winked at that receptionist and she also winked back. It almost made his day and he was very happy. A silent prison officer handcuffed the recaptured Evans, and together the two men clambered awkwardly into the back seat of the prison van. So they climbed the van back seat. They have taken Evans there. See you soon, Evans. It was almost as if the governor was saying farewell to an old friend after a cocktail party, and he was bidding farewell to Evans like he is bidding farewell to his friend. Governor is bidding farewell to his friend after a cocktail party. Cheerio, sir. I was just wondering. I know your German is pretty good, sir, but do you know any more these modern languages? He was asking. You know German also, sir? Do you know any other language? Not very well. Why? Ivan settled himself comfortably on the back seat and grinned happily. Nothing really. I just happened to notice that you have got some O-level Italian classes coming up next September. That's all. Evans was very happy to sit there in the back seat. He was happy. He was smiling and he was saying, see, now what will happen? Now O-level classes will be there again. But it will not be of German. It will be of Italian O-level classes. Perhaps you won't be with us next September, Evans, the governor said. But you will not be with us next September. James Roderick Evans appeared to ponder the governor's word deeply. No, perhaps I won't, he said. And he started thinking and he said, yes, perhaps I will not be there. As the prison van turned right from Chipping Norton onto the Oxford Road, the hitherto silent prison officer unlocked the handcuffs and leaned forwards toward the driver. Now they came from there and his handcuffs were open. The driver who was in the van, for Christ's sake, get a move on. It won't take them long to find out. And he said, for Christ's sake, get a move on. They will not find us long. So what does it mean? Now at last, in which van he was sitting, the driver was also his friend, and that was his plan to go in that van. And he was saying to him, move fast. It won't take them long to find out. They will find out also. So move fast. We have to go from there. Where do you suggest we make for? Driver said, where? Asked the driver. Where we have to go now? In a broad Scots accent. Do you remember the broad Scots accent? The same accent was there when that McLaren came to invigilate. So it was the same person who came there in the cell. So now at last also, Evans was able to escape from the jail, and he made the plan and he was able to escape from there. What about Newbury? Suggested Evans. And Evans said, now we'll go to Newbury. So this all happened in the chapter. Three times he already escaped the jail, fourth time again. Last time when the governor arrested him, again he made the plan with his friends and all, and he was able to escape from there. So this was the chapter, Evans tries and